Hey you guys, tonight we're going to do a custom tray order, and the colors are going to be black and fire colors. I've already mixed up 12 ounces of resin. I'm pretty sure I'm only going to need 10, but I'd rather not take a chance. So the colors I'm using for mica are Baltic Day, Pure Soul, Black Marble, and then Let's Resin Color Shift Orange. And Baltic Day, Pure Soul, Uncut Ruby. It's kind of it's not bright red, it's like blood red. Some PearEX Brilliant Gold. Then now, let's see how much that leaves us to work with. The base, it's 8 ounces. And to that 8 ounces, I'm going to use black acrylic craft paint. I know you can't see what I'm doing over here, but I'm making a mess. See? And that's part of the fun of working with resin. Okay, so let's give this a quick stir. This color is going to be laid down as our base color. Now, I always put my micas in first. Now, I've done it both ways, but this way always works better. I like to mix it up, scrape it along the sides to make sure you crush it up, and then what you're gonna do, let it sit for a minute, and the mica that's not mixed up will start breaking up and dissolving more, and then we can go back and give it another mix. I need to order more color shift micas. I love them so much, I've used them all. Got this heater going right behind me. Let's turn that off. You can probably hear me better. Sorry. Gotta remember. Keep it in view. Keep it in view. These aside, let them degas a little bit and let the micas play. Now, back to this. On the back of this, I taped it off already, so you don't have issues with resin sticking to your piece. Your hands, but we got a puppy recently, Belgian Malinois, and her name is Reba, and she is adorable. She's the cutest little werewolf I've ever seen. Sides right now, because I'm going to make sure that's done before I cut. Okay, from this point on, I have no plan. The logo is gonna go right in the center here. That much I know. So I think I'm gonna start with black. Although it's going to be fire colors, I'm not so concerned with a fire pattern. So, first things first, off the side, down the middle. I just hit the camera with my head, sorry. And then even it out on the sides. and just keep going until you're satisfied. The good thing is, if you don't like the way it looks, you can put a second layer . But I'm hoping this will be fine. They saw one of the TV trays I did, my Aces High tray, and were interested in tables for their tattoo parlor. They're in Yuma, Arizona. Stranded Ink. Check out their Instagram page. They're pretty darn good. Okay, now the ruby. Remember, it's your art. You can put as much or as little of yourself into it as you want. And when it starts to run thin, you could ribbon it, I call it, for little streaks. Orange and the red near each other. I wish I was a tattoo artist. Man, they are so talented. And our final color that we're going to add is the gold. Sit up some more. Okay. And this goes near the orange. What do you guys think? Now, I told myself before I started, the one thing I was not going to do was tilt it. So, no matter what happens, I'm not tilting. I've got a problem with tilting and I can't stop. Tilting is when you pick up and let the resin slide and it pulls the mica, which is an awesome thing to do and it's one of my favorites, but for this, I'm not. What I'm doing now is I'm taking over and I'm going back and forth like this, okay? I'm not holding it in one place too long because it'll burn the resin will start to smoke and that's toxic fumes, and because I'm filming, I'm not wearing a mask, so we're gonna be very careful. Okay, guess what? I frickin' lied. Alright, here we go. Can you hear it running off the sides? That'll give it a little play. Then, I think... I'm going to use a different nozzle. I'm going to use a concentrator nozzle to break up some of the lines. Ah, shit, that was stupid. Sorry. I just wiped the resin all over my gun. Which means when I heat it up... Hi. Okay. Tilt it the other way. Okay. Now, the last thing I'm going to do before we cover it for the night is run my hands along the side very gently so there's no blank spots. We want full coverage. I just want to say, anybody out there who's crafting or an artist with a disability, props, peeps. My fam. People with disabilities create amazing pieces of art. Just like everybody else. Alright, and that's it for tonight. We're gonna work on the second layer tomorrow. And we'll get to it then. Alright.
Hey, you guys, it's all done. Look at that. Look how smooth that is. I just love working with resin. That color shift works really well. Look at that. Chameleon powder, I think is what it's called. I just always call it color shift. I love how the black marble mica makes it look like smoke around the flames. I ain't gonna lie, I'm impressed. Try not to hit the camera. Oh, I have so many plans for this design. I want to do something similar with green flames as soon as I can figure out the best combination. I'll do that. But for now, this is complete, ready to be mailed out, and we will see you on our next project.